Hello friends, welcome back. In this tutorial we will study about mapping physical address to logical address. So for mapping physical address to logical address, there are three protocols: RARP, Bootstrap protocol, and DHCP. In this tutorial we will study only about two protocols, RARP and Bootstrap protocol. So what happens in RARP? The full form of RARP is Reverse Address Resolution Protocol, right? So this RARP, it finds the logical address for a machine which knows only its physical address. So what happens, this RARP, this Reverse Address Resolution Protocol, it finds the logical address for a machine which knows only its physical address. A machine can get its physical address which is unique locally, for example by reading its network interface card, right? Now the machine can use this physical address to get its logical address by using RARP protocol. So what happens in this case a RARP request is created and broadcast on the local network, right? Another machine on the local network that knows all the IP addresses will respond with RARP reply, right? So in this case what happens, the requesting machine, it must be running a RARP client program, and the responding machine must be running a RARP server program, right? So what happens in this case, in this protocol RARP, this protocol is used to find the logical address for a machine which knows only its physical address. A machine can get its physical address, right, which is unique locally. Actually a machine can get its physical address by reading its network interface card, for example, right? And then machine can use this physical address to get its logical address by using RARP protocol. So how it can get its logical address by using RARP protocol? Actually a RARP request is created and broadcast on the local network, and another machine on the local network that knows all the IP addresses, that machine will respond with RARP reply, right? So the requesting machine must be running a RARP client program, and the responding machine must be running a RARP server program, right? Now we will study about Bootstrap protocol. Now what happens in a Bootstrap protocol? Bootstrap protocol is an application layer protocol, and it is a client server protocol which provides a physical address to logical address mapping, right? This Bootstrap protocol is a client server protocol, and it provides physical address to logical address mapping. Now what happens, these Bootstrap protocol messages, they are encapsulated in a UDP packet, right? And UDP packet itself is encapsulated in an IP packet. So what happens in this protocol? In this protocol, client can be in one network and the server can be in another network, right? So what happens in a Bootstrap protocol, when a client requests its IP address, the Bootstrap protocol server consults a table which matches the physical address of the client with its IP address, right? So what happens in this case, when a client knows its physical address and it needs its IP address, then what it does, it broadcast Bootstrap protocol request, right? So what happens in this protocol, in this case what happens, when a client knows its physical address and it needs IP address, then that client broadcasts Bootstrap protocol request, right? And this Bootstrap protocol request is picked up by Bootstrap protocol server, right? And this Bootstrap protocol server replies to the client, right? Now what happens, when client is in one network and this Bootstrap protocol server, it is in another network, then there is a problem, right? So what happens in this case, what is the problem? The problem is that the broadcast request cannot pass through any router. Therefore what happens, therefore there is a need of intermediary, right? And therefore what we do, one of the host is used as relay, and it is called relay agent, right? So the relay agent, it knows the unicast address of the bootstrap protocol server, right? So what happens when this relay agent receives a bootstrap protocol request packet, it encapsulates that packet in a unicast datagram and it sends that datagram, or we can say that request, to the bootstrap protocol server, right? Now this packet which is carrying a unicast destination address, it reaches the bootstrap protocol server, right? So what this bootstrap protocol server does, this bootstrap protocol server sends the reply to the relay agent, and the relay agent, after receiving the reply, sends it to the bootstrap protocol client.